In this video, I'll answer the question, what is an ECN broker in the Forex markets? Well, an ECN broker, for starters, stands for Electronic Communication Network. So really what happens is in the Forex world, there are a couple of different ways that trades happen. In one example, and this is the oldest model, there is a group of money, and this is represented by your broker, and this is all of the clients and the money that they have. And trader A will place a trade, and on the other side of that trade is the broker. Now, they'll charge a flat pip spread, say 3 pips for, you know, say you're trading, I don't know, like euro yen or even pound yen, and it's a 3 pip spread. In this environment, this is called a market maker, and the broker is trading against you. So what I mean by that is, it doesn't necessarily mean they're doing anything nefarious, but as you make money, they lose money. They collect the 3 pips regardless as payment, the spread, and then, you know, if you win $10, then they're down $10 minus the 3 pip spread. Now, that was the model for ages, and this is called a market maker. So I'll just put an MM there. Now, there is straight through processing, and they use what is known as a liquidity pool, which an ECN also uses. And this would be your broker here. And this would be broker 2, broker 3, broker 4. So what they have here is a liquidity pool. That's where a bunch of money gets thrown in. And all of these brokers are connected to it, including yours. Trader A takes a trade. The broker sends it out there. They pay the 3 pip spread. The real spread is something only the broker knows. And in this environment, depending on what's going on in the market, it might be very tight. It might be 0.4 pips. So what happens is, in this case, the broker makes 2.6 pips regardless of what happens with your money. Furthermore, they do not lose money based upon what you're doing. So if you're down $50, they aren't up $50. Just like if you make $50, they aren't down $50. They keep the 2.6 spread. Now, an ECN is a bit different. It's a lot like this in its structure, but the difference here is you have the liquidity pool where all of the money is stored, and you'll have several brokers. So these are a bunch of brokers, and this is your brokerage firm right here that you're trading with. And you place a trade, and what they do is, in this same example up here, if the spread is 0.4 pips, they'll show 0.4 pips, and your trade is thrown in here. And in both of these, you could win or lose. And it will match an order. Maybe let's just say it comes from broker 2 in both scenarios. So you're trading against some trader over here. You don't know who it is. It doesn't really matter. You buy 10,000 pounds against the Japanese yen. They're trying to sell 10,000 pounds against the Japanese yen. And your order gets matched up. The difference between the bid and the ask is 0.4 of a pip. So that's where you're at. Now, what happens here in the ECN is this broker has a predetermined price, and it'll be plainly known. It might be like $3 per every 100,000 units trade, like a full lot. So in this case, we're trading a tenth of a lot. So you would pay a 0.4 spread plus the commission of, in that case, it would be, you know, roughly 33 cents. Your broker keeps that. Doesn't matter what happens here. So instead of padding what the actual spread is, they make the difference in error. They charge a specific amount of commission. Now ask yourself, what's the advantage and disadvantage for the broker here? Well, the advantage for the broker over here is, under most circumstances, this spread is going to be about this, and they know that, and they'll get anywhere from like 2 to 6, 2.6, 2.4, 2.7, whatever, on a consistent basis. However, there are times where they started to run into trouble here, because in a very illiquid market, like at non-farm payroll, maybe the spread jumps to 17 pips. Well, for a while, they were charging a flat rate. And the problem is, and some of them still do, the problem that they have there is you are buying, but they're actually 15 pips, almost 15 pips in the hole immediately because of what you trade. Now, most of the time, you're going to see conditions like this, but there was the occasional time when they were losing a bunch of money. So in an ECN environment, they will just simply show you this same spread in that non-farm payroll, and you can choose whether or not you're going to trade it, and they're going to make their 33 cents or $3.33 per 100,000, regardless of what the spread is. And they don't care what happens after that. Other than in this scenario, they want you to be a client for longer. They want you to be successful because it means you'll be paying them more. It's kind of like a stock market broker. A stock broker actually wants you to be successful, so you keep paying for services. It used to be commissions. That's kind of going by the wayside in the U.S., probably going to follow suit everywhere else. But their interests are much more aligned with you with an ECN. And you already know your costs going in. You make the decision whether or not you're willing to deal with a 17 pip spread, which, you know, hint, you should not be. And then that way it protects them in this scenario and this scenario here, because those who are market makers quite often will have fixed spreads. So it'll always be 3 pips. So they could take a loss even if they quote-unquote beat you, so to speak, in that trade. So an ECN is definitely the way to go, probably 95% of the time. Doesn't mean there's anything nefarious going on here. It's just that this is where you and the broker are aligned as far as your interests are concerned.